June 11th, 2015. 9/11 was an inside job. It's falling apart. It's not the way they kept trying to tell you it happened, because it didn't happen that way. Now, check out our garden already. I just didn't videotape the cucumbers we had pulled out on the counter in the house. Wife just came out here with a basket of the canning basket just to get some beans, just a few beans now. Remember, June 11th. And look at that basket full of beans.
And they're tasty too.
Yeah, let me get a good one.
Sitting here eating them.
These are purple pole beans. Mm-hmm. Where are they in the garden? Those should be the canela beans. That's why I don't understand.
Yeah, those are purple pole beans.
Eat them raw. Oh, get off of there!
Sweet too.
Mm-hmm.
Tastes good.
Eating beans, I wouldn't suggest eating a lot of beans like this, but you can eat them right off the vine.
Any kind of raw vegetable, I mean, that's good for you.
Yeah, as long as you don't eat
all the nutrients, you don't cook them.
You wouldn't eat that whole basket raw, though. You'd get sick. I'm just saying, you could have a couple of them.
If you eat a big plate full of them cooked, you'd get sick.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my solar panel over here. Finally did what I was going to do last year. I got my solar generator right inside there. I ran my freezer on it last night, fully charged. But I haven't been doing this. You're supposed to do it, that run down and recharge it, and run down and recharge it. I charge it up and let it sit for like 3 months, 4 months sometimes, which is bad.
Did you get the cucumbers?
No, I didn't. I said I walked right out past the cucumbers and didn't get them. I'll get those in a minute. But these are peppers we put out. The biggest one that was out here, you can see on previous video, about that size right there. And that one's small, but still we'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 of them have grown quite a bit. It's been about a week or two. Well, I don't want to make this a long video, so let me hurry up and get over here. The only thing in this entire garden, I broke down and got 4 tomato plants at the Kmart. At the Kmart in Jackson, Tennessee, they said they were heirloom tomatoes. There's 4 of them. They're beefsteak. Stay off this. Everything else is from seed. Everything. These are the purple pole beans. Wow, this came up. It seemed almost, I swear to you, overnight. These were not here yesterday. I put 2 painted pole beans there on there. I mean, a couple days back, but look at that. Almost overnight. See, it's the heat now that's coming. Now, this is going to be a challenge. I got one right there before this pumpkin grew out like it has. Okay, see, this broken viewfinder, but right down there, there were 2 more put down there. I don't know. I might not be able to grow that because of these pumpkins. But these are the supposed to be the canela running beans. I don't know why purple. They look like purple pole beans. Maybe this is canela. But I could have sworn I planted canela runner beans out here on all this. But these look just like purple pole beans, which is fine too. I mean, these are growing. If these are canelas, ones with little white flowers. Bees have been out here. Look at all over that. Look at, see that plant over there? Let me see if I can't see it on the viewfinder. They're big like bumblebees all over the flowers over there. I'm just going to hold this steady for a few minutes. You see bees? Look, there's a bee right here on this one. See, that jerked away right away. These big bees are out here like pollinating these. They're out all over the place out here. That was the reason I did all these sunflowers. Those, torch sunflowers and the Titan sunflowers. I planted on that little piece of this first garden and the whole back row over there, the northern side of the garden. Those are all Titan sunflowers. I didn't put no torch over there. I should have. Next year I'll definitely put torch up around because they got the big shady leaves on them. All right, go back over there on the porch. This is a straight 8 cucumber. See, look how cute crowded these are, too. These cucumbers, there's 5 or 6 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. six with these two straight eight. This is a straight eight. Well, God, again, just viewfinder right there, I think it is. And there's two of them here, two cucumber plants. We've got a bunch of cucumbers in the house, I get. And then there's that, God, I can't get to this. I've tried walking over this before and ended up getting my foot caught in. Shoot, stepped on a plant. This one right here. See, there's just this one plant right here, it's a straight eight. I move this away. You see, straight eight right here. And this one there, the one at the end there, I have one, two, three, I think. And that's a straight eight. And that's one, there's two here, two or three here. Look at how crowded they are. This garden really took off a lot better than I ever thought it would. I knew it would get good, it'd be good, but not like this. See, there's a view. I can't see with the viewfinder, so you just have to kind of look for yourself under. There's bumblebees, or I don't know if they're honeybees or bumblebees, or whatever, all over these flowers. Pollinate reasons. Huh? I know. Like I said, this is, I just said, I didn't realize it would be this bountiful. I mean,
well, we have tried it for 2 years,
which,
you know.
Yeah, for 2 years we had done this, and we got about 20%. Now we got 95%. Everything that we planted coming up. Oh,
Lucy,
man.
Lucy, get
over here. What's she at? Lucy, get over by mommy. Look at all the flowers on this. This is honeydew. These are honeydew right here. There's two of them. One there and one here. Planted. This one was planted a little bit later, about maybe 3 weeks later, because nothing was growing. So I waited 3 weeks and planted it. But look at all the flowers on there. And like I say, there's your bees right there. Again, I can't see. Somewhere around there is a bee. See? Pollinating these. Man, those are all gonna be honeydew, which is cool. Planted four watermelons, two different types, and only one of each grew. This is one of the, there was a watermelon right there planted. Can't see on the viewfinder. And I covered it up with the X over there, but this one and this one were two different types of watermelons across from each other, and that one, two different types. So this one and that one there are different watermelons. And then this one that's right here would be the same as the one that's in the back right there. And the opening here that I covered back up, you can see the X. See, this is how you cut the plastic. You cut it like in an X, and then you fold it up underneath, and the heat generates the soil for it to grow up out of there. So, but nothing's growing, so I kind of like, I was going to try doing it loosely, not completely closed, and see if anything would happen from that. But, see, there's a zucchini there, nothing came up. Look at all the rest of them, though. These are well up above my waist, and spread out. The golden zucchini down in here. Can't see crap. Not as a viewfinder, so. Whatever comes out, comes out. I can't see on the viewfinder, so I can't videotape what I'm looking at. I'm just giving you a broad view of it. These were watermelon, pumpkin. I planted these two. I knew these were pumpkin, but I thought they would run the opposite way, but they're running north. So, let's see where it's planted right there. I know there's one, if you can see it. They're running north out into the yard there. You see pumpkins forming. There's a green one right here, a pumpkin. If you can see that, I don't know where. If I get close, I can get the viewfinder right there. Okay, that's it. But then we got black-eyed peas here. That first one started growing, then it died off. And that one's growing now. I put two beans down there, and black-eyed peas. Lucy! Lucy! Lucille! Go by mommy! Okay, God, man, making a video, constantly yelling. These are all black-eyed peas. And then it goes right to purple hull peas. I gotta kill that bug. Sorry, I'm not one of those people that is very anti-nature or anything, but I'm holding the camera right now, so I can't spray it with anything. I have to actually step on the damn thing. Purple hull peas. Okay, these are all black eyed peas. All this, I realized it. These are all black eyed peas, black eyed peas, black eyed peas. This one here, the last one in this row, is purple hull pea. Purple hull pea, purple hull pea, purple hull pea. Now those are from my mom's garden. Before she passed away, she gave me some purple hull peas. And last year, again, the garden just didn't take off worth anything. We put this plastic down and I'd say 95% or 90% is growing. And we overplanted as a result because we didn't know how it would come out like that would come out like this. Next year it'll be a little spread out differently. The stuff will be rotated a little bit, nothing in the same spot for sure. But now we know from this, provided the country doesn't go under, well, it's not gonna go under, but we'll have to see what it's like. The okra and all that will be more this way, more on this side of the garden. And it'll be like a garden, it'll be a row of okra. Then it'll be, I don't know, a bean plant. See, look how these beans are. The beans are gonna stay together, not here though. But you can see how this is. Well, I just got a basket of them today. So we'll have beans tonight, purple hull peas, purple pole beans. Purple hull, purple pole, da 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 da. Purple pole beans. See, there's an okra coming up right there. I've replanted in here several times. You can see it right down there. Anyway. I mean, this again, I keep saying it and saying it, but I don't do anything about it. I need to buy more, about 50 more of these tomato steaks. But I'd like to get like the green ones there. They were four in a pack for $3.99. It's kind of expensive, but they're real sturdy, and I've used one pack. I got three up there for like a fence for those beans. I put one on the end. I can't see into the viewfinder, but somewhere around there, it's a green one that goes at the end of them string fences I made. See, they're starting to go on here. These are not really strong enough. I put them down, I thought as best as I could, but like over here, I had two of them yesterday or the day before yesterday, because the weight of these beans is not real heavy, but you know, yeah, with all these beans, they fell over, they broke off. And again, we got, I'm gonna stand in the north end of the garden looking south. Okay, in the okra. And there's a peanut plant over there somewhere. Another one over there somewhere. The camera's in the general area. And then you got okra plants. The ones with the red stems are burgundy okra. It's an heirloom seed, of course. All everything out here is heirloom seed, except for those four tomato plants, allegedly are heirloom tomatoes from Kmart. We'll see what happens with that. Everything out here came from seed. Everything. Every single thing out here. Okay. There's a couple pepper plants that we put out that we grew inside for a while, and then we put them out by the house over there. Put a few in the garden on the number two garden. All the sunflowers. See sunflowers here? That's over my head, some of those sunflowers right there. I made like a wall. I'm going to walk into the garden going, there's supposed to be two more, one there somewhere and one around the end. They're not growing, I don't understand that. But anyway, yeah, I made like a wall with those sunflowers, and we had deer over here that ate. Those were on all the tops, eat off the tops of those last smaller sunflowers there for like the last 3 feet. But you see they're growing back already, so I left a little break right there, but now I got the string there. Look where I'm walking before. And sunflower all the way down. Broccoli, we messed up on that, and it's no good. I'm gonna see about planting them in 5 gallon buckets on the porch next year. Peas, beans, black eyed peas, zucchini, honeydew, watermelon, beans, again, beer, cucumber, beans, again, these were supposed to be, I thought, canela beans, but they look like purple pole beans. Can't really see on the viewfinder, so again, you have to bear with me. If you catch it, you know, pause it on the video, on your camera, on your viewer, whatever, your screen. If you watch this on full screen, you'll get a better view of it all, too. Okay, we got two different types of beans over here. I think those may be the canela beans, the one with the white flowers. I'm not sure. But I didn't think I planted that many purple pole beans. And the okra. Okay, coming out of the number three garden into the number one garden. Overwhelmed with pumpkin, which I, again, I thought at the time was zucchini, but look at how that's come over. And the bees are pollinating the hell out of those, too. The heck, for those who can't understand what hell is not that big of a deal for a lot of people, but it is for some. A heck of a lot of pumpkin right here. And there's like five plants here. And if I'd known it was pumpkin and it was going to be like this, I would put two maximum. Two here and then two on the other side in garden three. But this is only like 14 and a half feet north to south. And they're running out. Over there, those two in the corner are running 14 feet out of the garden or more so. Now I'm at the south end of garden one. Tomatillos, pumpkin, and then these beans, and there's a pepper plant I put out here. I wasn't sure it would make it. I didn't mean to put it out here too, because I was gonna put the painted pony bean, but at that time I just wasn't thinking clearly. When I put it down, there was a pepper plant somewhere in there. And then the purple pole bean, I put two. I'm not sure if it was, the seed was, it's either a cucumber or it's honeydew again, right there, two seeds. Then the four Kmart alleged heirloom tomatoes, beefsteak tomatoes. And then this tomato we grew in the house. These are from heirloom seeds now. Tomato plant we grew in the house. We thought this was a pepper, but it looks more like a tomato, so that's another one that came from in the house. And then these are peppers. Pepper. 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 Nothing, that's just a post for the string. That's a chard, Swiss chard, which don't know how to eat the stuff even yet, but we got it. So we got Swiss chard. Then over here, I haven't planted it yet. I went over here. Emperor beans, which is the real big maroon-like bean. I planted one right there about 2 or 3 days ago. One right down there. See, and then two, a bean from the capsule. I can't remember the bean now, but it's two of them. I put two in there and I put two in there to go run north. Okay. Over here, I just cut the plastic. I didn't put anything in yet. I got a cut right here by my foot. Just cut there, cut here, cut here, cut here. Gosh, I can't see. A cut there, a cut here. I had planted a couple peppers here, but the storms we had here, they weren't sturdy enough. Got rid of those two. I planted peppers here. And these were all peppers here. So that's a small one down there. There were two more here. The storm got rid of those two. So we got more peppers we're growing, so that we'll have about 14 peppers at least here, 14 or 15, 16 peppers in these two rows. And tomatoes, possibly here and here. And depending on how it is, I don't know with these beans, how it'll work. Might put it in between these beans. I don't think so, though. Depends. Again, this is all on the fly for the fifth year of actually doing anything, but the third year of actually trying hard. And like I said, when I got the plastic from Andy, who's our mailman, and he's the road commissioner in Crockett County out here. I hope that's not gonna get him in trouble. Anyway, he knew a farmer who had this plastic that he used to sell. He used to sell his crop to wherever on the market. And when he was done, he let me have this big piece of plastic, which I cut into three pieces, my wife and I. It was rough, 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 but we did it. And it's better than what it has been the last, let's just say the 3 years that the garden has been somewhat of a garden. But the last 2 years are just crap. We got a little bit out. We got cherry tomatoes, which ended up taking over when we had them going east to west, which is a bad way. We wanted to go north to south. I feel that's the best way. But you can see how it's crowded. We're going to have to try doing it a little differently next year. We might have the zucchini on the left side. Or we might even just have the zucchini up here in the garden one. Tomatillos again. I want about 4 tomatillos instead of just 2. One of them, the wind blew it over, completely over, man. It's messed up, but it's better. It's come. It seems like it's not dead. It's not 100%. Excuse me. But we got tomatillos on. You can see the yellow leaves from it too, being knocked over. The wind knocked it over, and I put that stake in there since then, in the middle of that cage. The cage was knocked over too, by the way. So the wind out here, you know, with this corn, this Monsanto corn, double-edged sword, you know, you got that Monsanto crap, but it's going to be kind of like a windbreak, I guess. Like I said, I've shown in past videos, everything around us, nothing but Monsanto corn. That's about 3/4 of a mile away to Highway 79. So you got my coordinates, if you want. At this point in the game, or if you want to call it a game, at this point in life and time, I don't give a shit what anybody wants to try. Just try it. I'm not rolling over. I'm not giving up anything. Anybody wants to try to take something, it'll be met with force. I don't have a problem saying that either. So, you think you want it that bad? Is your life worth it? Mine is. I'll fight for whatever I have. So, it's a garden. We got a lot of beans out today. First day we actually got beans. We had a couple, 4 or 5 the other day. We were eating them right out of the garden. My wife got that basket of beans. I'm going to see if I can get cucumbers on here before this gets much louder. I got my solar panel in there to help run my freezer and my refrigerator off of, so I'm not using electricity for that. And my biggest fear is a solar flare, which will burn up everything. I had it in a fairway cage, but I can't keep it put in a fairway cage for 2 or 3 months, which I have done. So, got to take it out and take a chance. I wish I had a place where I could quickly get it in a fairway cage. See the cucumbers. Notice the squeaks, don't you? Thinking I can sneak in here? Here's your cucumbers. Nice dill pickles. If you knew how to make dill pickles, we're gonna look up that. Cucumbers and that big golden squash. I mean zucchini squash. Well, it's a squash either way. And there's that big basket of purple pole beans. Oh, man. And this is the third attempt tray with these tomatoes and peppers over here. It's assorted stuff. I've got it in labeled on the other side. I've got so far just that one. That's a super sue. I know that. I looked at that last night. That was coming up. I thought putting 2 seeds in the planter now again, because there's one right here. You see 2 seeds in there. One coming up there. One barely come up there. One there. One there. One there. I see there's 2 in that one. And down here, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That one there in that plastic container might be transplanted. Man, it's warm in here. Hot now. Should have that air on over there. I'll turn it on. But that's it, see? For the time being, I'll have this little solar generator. Oh, I should turn that off, shouldn't I? It's charging. I'll put power. Let's see. I just put that out there. It was 0 this morning. Sun's coming up. It's got 30% on here now. So, again, I don't know. Do I need to leave this on while it's charging?
I don't know. Where's the manual for it?
Online. Let's see. Because the battery light is flashing. And it says battery level 30%. Output power is zero right now because nothing's plugged into it. See, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to let it stay off for about 10 or 15 minutes to see if it's actually going to charge it up enough. Otherwise, I'll leave it on. And I just run my freezer and refrigerator off it for a few hours, about 6 to 8 hours.